Kentucky snow. And my bones are fairly shaking. The winter in its wake. The land I'm cultivating. And I watch a detonation of crows out of the dogwood, where the leaves are quit attempting, and which hazel is empty, just like everything is dead, exempting me out in the cold. Oh, 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 oh. Like the devil was a cropper on my family's farming proper. Tiny bones and head of copper in the loam, shivering to death. He wasn't moving, and I knew the antidote. But he rose up in my throat, and so I put him in my coat to keep him warm, carry him back home. Oh, 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 oh. Well, why shouldn't I oversimplify? It's got to be alive. So logically, if not misunderstood, no, I will not play God, arbitrating, arrogantly designating who should live. Well, then it happened. I bet you already guessed. When I called the cursed blessed, he stuck his fang into my chest and through my shirt, put his venom in my veins. As I was dying, well, I thought it rather fitting that my heart produced that pity, and that's the place that snake bit me. And I know nature doesn't want changed. No. Oh. 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 But I I didn't realize the demon at my door. Well, with one slash of Sheol's knife, he cut down the tree of life. Stuck to folk and then the laughter that I'm sure will follow after this life.